Yeah.
Is that why you keep it in your safe?
Uh-huh.
And that, of course, is Walter Matthau as Mr. Wilson being tormented by young Mason Gamble in Dennis the Menace, the new film from writer-producer John Hughes. And this is sort of a hit-and-miss affair, with most of the hits coming from Walter Matthau in a terrific comic performance as the long-suffering neighbor, Mr. Wilson. Here's an example of his relationship with Dennis in one of the cute scenes in the movie.
What's the combination to your lock?
Ha! You're the last person in the world I tell that to.
You got it wrote down someplace?
It's in my head.
What's that mean?
It means I know it. I remember it.
What about if you forget it?
I won't forget it. It's a familiar number. I won't forget it.
What's that mean?
It means it's a number that I use all the time, so I won't forget it. I use it all the time.
I bet I know what it is.
I doubt that.
I bet it's your address.
Even better than the humor are the all too few tender moments between Mr. Wilson and Dennis.
You know, Mr. Wilson, you know why I'm not crying? Because if I'm not going to be around my mom and dad, the only other person I want to be around is you.
But there's a story to tell. Unfortunately, it's about Dennis being held hostage by a thief played by Christopher Lloyd, who has stolen Mr. Wilson's gold coin.
Put a cork in it. You're giving me a headache.
I don't have a cork.
Shut your mouth.
I can't because my nose is stuffed because of my allergies. If I shut my mouth, I can't breathe good.
Then keep your mouth open, but don't talk.
A little of that goes a long way. Still, I came close to giving this movie, which is directed by Nick Castle, a thumbs up, but I decided against it because I really got bored with the thief. There are lots of dull hijinks with him, even duller pratfalls than those with the thieves in another recent John Hughes production, Home Alone 2. I don't know why we needed the thief in the first place. I wish the story could have centered more on Dennis and Mr. Wilson, because theirs is the one and only relationship in the film that works. When Matthau is not on the screen, Dennis the Menace is dull indeed.
You're right, and you're right about the character played by Christopher Lloyd.
Wow.
Now, his name is Switchblade Sam,
yeah.
And he is an apparently homeless person.
Oh, it's
very
gonna...
dirty, very menacing,
yes.
Very angry, very violent, and always displaying his switchblade,
yes.
And tying up little boys.
It's...
And I know that it's supposed to be comedic and innocent, but images like that disturb me, and I think they will also disturb the young children, and this is a movie that's always going to appeal to really young children.
That's correct.
And they're going to be disturbed by that. And you know what?
They're going to think that every homeless person on the street has a knife.
Or that they might be waiting outside their bedroom window.
Yes.
Why did the people who made this movie feel that they had to go back to screenwriting 101, it was John Hughes who wrote the screenplay,
yeah.
And introduce a villain in order that you can have the formula by the numbers plot?
Yeah.
Why not have the effort to write a relationship between Dennis and Mr. Wilson?
Absolutely.
And then play it out?
If they had had them having to work together on a project, Dennis and Mr. Wilson,
yeah.
Where the kid is constantly foiling him, and so that they become enemies, they're so good
they
together.
They have a common goal, but they
yes.
Can't get there because Dennis
yes.
Screws everything up.
Yes.
Instead of this ridiculous, cliched, unnecessary villain.
And the time that it takes. It's,
oh,
there's,
you're right.
There's 10 extra minutes there. If you're going to even throw it in, shorten it.
You're right. When we come back, a character makes a journey.